We will invest more than $3 billion to conduct research on an advanced heavy lift rocket, a vehicle to efficiently send into orbit the crew capsules, propulsion systems, and large quantities of supplies needed to reach deep space. So the point is, what we're looking for is not just to continue on the same path, we want to leap into the future. We want major breakthroughs, a transformative agenda for NASA. The bottom line is, nobody is more committed to manned spaceflight, to human exploration of space, than I am. And by 2025, we expect new spacecraft designed for long journeys to allow us to begin the first ever crewed missions beyond the moon into deep space. So we'll start by the mid-2030s. I believe we can send humans to orbit Mars and return them safely to Earth. And a landing on Mars will follow. And I expect to be around to see it.
Ultimately tens of thousands, eventually millions of people to Mars and then going out there and exploring the stars.
Musk is the CEO and chief technology officer of 10-year-old Space Exploration Technologies, as it is more formally known. He has staked $100 million of the fortune he made founding PayPal to pursue a lofty goal to make access to space an order of magnitude cheaper than it is right now.
Is there any doubt in your mind that this is the way NASA and the country should go as it looks toward the future in space?
No, not at all. This is not a path, it's the only path that will succeed. If this doesn't succeed, nothing will.
All right, so what do we
have?
So what we're looking at here, Miles, is
mission control. All right. This is where we operate Dragon from.
Gwen Shotwell, the president at SpaceX, walked me through the factory. Here they are aiming for the Holy Grail, a fully and rapidly reusable rocket. It would revolutionize access to space.
These engines actually are reusable.
They are.
Absolutely.
How many flights can you get?
I know we've tested to 20.
Those engines are built here from scratch, and that is typical. More than two-thirds of Falcon and Dragon parts are milled, made, and mated right here.
We're trying to push the state of the art of technology. So if we use suppliers that are just producing the old technology, then we're not going to have a revolutionary rocket.
The Falcon Dragon combination is obviously much simpler than a space shuttle. No wings, wheels, or cargo compartments.
Liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis.
The cost of launching anything into space on a shuttle was about $10,000 a pound. Musk believes he can drive that number down below $1,000. Veteran space journalist Stephen Young believes Musk can do it.
I think going back to something a little more basic, sort of capsule that SpaceX is going to fly, will reduce costs dramatically and open up a lot more opportunities for research in orbit.
But hauling underwear and food to the space station is one thing. Flying astronauts is another. And SpaceX wants to start doing that by 2015. Turns out they've been thinking about flying humans from the outset.
And that's why the Falcon 9 was designed with much higher factors of safety, more than the standard expendable launch vehicle.
Launch.
Stop.
The testing is exhaustive to what engineers call the corners of the flight envelope, meaning the absolute edge of a vehicle's capability.
You can rest assured that on a NASA-driven human spaceflight exploration program, we will test in all the corners, right?
So it's this is what Cost Plus is all about, isn't it? Doing when you have to do all this, right?
Exactly right.
Last jettison, FBC jettison.
Everyone agrees sending humans to space will never get cheaper if this remains the approach.
That went like clockwork, from what I could see.
But the old guard is leery of retooling. Orion is designed to take up 7 astronauts to low Earth orbit and beyond. But where? The destination has changed repeatedly.
did. It was going to be a lifeboat for the space station. It was going to take crew to the station. It was going to go to the moon at one point. Then it was going to go to Mars. And now it might go to an asteroid. Is this really the way to build a space program?
Well, no. No. Is there any way to run a railroad? No. Okay.
And the political and budgetary winds keep shifting. When the Obama administration canceled the family of rockets that would have lofted Orion into space under the Constellation scheme, Congress got into the act. Senator Bill Nelson, a Florida Democrat who flew on Columbia in 1986 with current NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden, insisted the agency build a heavy-lift rocket that uses shuttle-derived components, again, with no clear destination in mind.
Is it a rocket to nowhere?
It's a rocket to Mars. That's the goal. The president has said that's the goal, and that's where we're going.